Welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to my reaction to Pearl Jam. And I'm going to react to the song Even Flow. This is my first time listening to the song. Let's get started with the song right away.
Concrete, yeah. Oh, feeling
fantastic vocals, good drums, and fabulous guitar riffs. I like the guitar work on this one. This is fulsome. This was awesome guitar playing throughout the song. I like the vocals. I like those, you know, saying one word and then speeding up with the rest of the words. Then saying one word and then speeding up and saying the rest of the words. And the same way was the guitar playing. It was pacing up just like the way it was sung. And the drummer was just tagging along with everyone. So his role was there, but not there so much. And it was more about the vocals and the guitarist kind of getting on the same page as the vocalist. I like the way this is sung, and definitely very deep lyric writing here. It's a, you know, it's an easy world and very easy to pursue career. It is very easy to do things the way you like it, the way you want it. You know, if your shower breaks, it's very easy to get it replaced the same day within few hours because you can't do without it. If you feel hungry, it's very easy to order food or on your phone. Just get in, get to any online portal where you can order pizza or whatever food you want. It's very easy. The world is very easy, convenient, very comfortable. The way it is right now, there is no trouble at all. But the only trouble is provided. There is only one caveat. There is only one condition. All of these things happen. The easy and comfort and the convenience that comes in our lives comes at a cost. The only thing required for all of these things to happen, the magical fingers when they work on our smartphones and we get everything availed in no time. Almost everything is you know, moved online as well as offline. You can go out or you can get things ordered out at home. All of these things are very, very easy for us in this world at this moment, where those mechanisms have been set and those services are available. But you need money. You need money. The only requirement, the only condition, the only catch is you need money to make those payments. And you can get almost anything you want. Let's not get into the quality of things. What is the quality and what exactly is happening in that department. But I'm talking about how our dreams can be fulfilled, how our wishes are granted. It's literally our phones, the internet has become a wish granting genie, which can grant as many wishes as we want. But the only catch is the genie wants money, 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 money. Every time you have a wish, pay some money and you get it granted. You have it. You have it. You have it. You have it standing outside your door. You just have to go and open the door, receive it. That is how simple life is in today's time. You want to study something, things are online, things are offline, whichever way you want to go. As long as a person has money, things are easy, things are very, very convenient in the world that we are living. Also, less difficulties in your life when you have to travel, you have your own vehicle. It is much less a difficulty, much less a sweating out, much lesser of running around. I know when we take a public transport and that comparison with the your private vehicle, it's a day-night difference. People may think you're still traveling by a vehicle, but you have to also count the time that is taken from your home to those stations, to those stops where you are supposed to take those public transport vehicles, and the additional time that you spend on the staircase, getting out of those stations, buying the tickets, or maybe booking it online, whatever. But it takes, there are a lot of steps for it. Whereas it is, when it is private, you get out of your house, wherever you park your car, get in there, and you're sorted. After that, you don't have to worry that you have to climb these many steps, or, you know, it's going to take some time. It's going to take a while to get into. And if it is crowded, peak hours, this, that, so many people, what will be the temperament of the people, and how are you going to come back alive at the end of the day? That is how difficult it seems. But when you have money, all of these problems are already eliminated. I know you people work very hard for the money that they have so that they can have comfortable life. Here we are talking about a person who doesn't have that money, who doesn't have this comfort, who does not have this convenience, who does not have this leisure, who cannot just you know, think of something and just do it. His thoughts also flow like a butterfly in his mind, but what does he have to do? He has to chase them away. He has to literally find a way to get rid of them because he can't really fulfill all of those thoughts as they keep coming. I was watching this chess movie. I don't remember the name right now. It's a new movie and it's an amazing movie about chess games. How this public school students from USA, in some part of USA, they wanted to participate in the chess competition of the state level first. First the local level, then the state level, and then they go for the national level and they kind of win it. It's a real story, based on a real story. So you may know or you can find out about it. What happens, this is the story of a school where in the public school, these students are there. They are very bright and they are very good chess players, but they have difficult lives, just like Dangerous Minds, that kind of a plot. But here that was a different thing altogether. It was mainly based on the ghetto and the way they manage their schooling as well as their life, personal life. Here it is about their passion for chess, their skill, their talent in chess, and their teacher's role in their life and their lives in general, and how things get affected. So for these children, even though they are very smart, they are very talented, they have the ability to conquer everything. They have the ability to win every contest or tournament they went for. But the only thing is, the thoughts they keep on coming like butterflies. They have big dreams, they have colorful dreams, they have a phoenix sized dreams in their minds. But to fulfill them, they need resources, and all of those resources, most of the times, they don't have. So for those resources, they have to resort to things or just give up on their dreams. That is what is the sad reality of this world is. Even though children are brighter, those who are living in the ghetto, those who are living in the slums, they are very bright kids, but they don't have the resources. And there comes a point where they get so fed up of the entire system and the way things work around, because it's always suppressing them, it's always discouraging them, it's always demoralizing the way they think, the way they want to do things. They want to just open, get, feel open and feel free to fly. But the wings are being cropped all the time, they are being cut off all the time, they are nailed to the ground because of the lack of resources. And that is the reason why they get very frustrated, and at times they commit crimes that they shouldn't have done because of that frustration, because of that anger, because of that anguish that they are living with 24/7, because they have the skills that is required to reach the highest spot, but they can't get there because they aren't blessed. I'll just put it simply, they aren't as blessed as some other people are. And the richer society who are blessed, you often see, and especially if you see from the point of view of those kids, those young aspirants, their aspirations are so high, but there is nobody who's willing to support them to the end, or they don't have the right connections. Let's put it straight, there are people who are willing to help them, they could help them and they could change their lives, but the bridge is not there. We don't have the right connections at the right time, meeting the right people at the right time. And whereas when they look at other people, especially the richer class, and when their children aren't really that smart or are indulging into the drug abuse and many other vices like that, they feel life is so unfair. Whereas I'm so talented and I wanted to do so many things, but I can't do because of limited resources or no resources at all. They see that people have resources, but they aren't really interested in doing anything. They are just wasting their life on this planet. So it's a very unfair world, and that is what we live with. Though here he's hopeful one day he'll be able to do all of that. He'll be able to lift himself out of this life. And that's a good thing. I like the way it was sung. I definitely like the way saying that one word and then, expanding it very quickly like that. This is a good song by Pearl Jam. I think many of their songs are very hard-hitting lyrically. This is one such, just adds to the feather. That's all. Thank you.